Hi, and welcome to Cofounder Collaboration Program. This is chapter 2 about alignment. And what I mean with alignment is that we want similar things in such a way that what I desire helps you to get what you desire, and vice versa. But before going into alignment details, let's look into one experience story. I was working with a scale-up CEO, let's call him Andrew, when he was running a team of 15 people after a 2 million euro seed round. The team was growing, sales were growing, but he had anxiety about properly using these funds and leading the growing team. But soon after the investment, what he realized that the sales were not growing according to the forecast and what was promised to the investors and the team, and with time the sales growth even started to decrease, and that caused additional anxiety. We were looking at the reasons why it was so, and what he uncovered was that he did not feel emotional connection to what the customers were buying the solution for and to the customers themselves. It was more like Excel type of business that it makes sense to do it. And then for a while we tried to find this deeper meaning with which he could connect and feel attached to, but he could not find it. Eventually what happened, he sold his shares to the co-founder and left the company, because his realization was that he wasn't doing what he actually desired to be doing in this company. And what could be the other way to pivot the company into something else? It was a bit too late for that. And also it wasn't actually possible, because the co-founder liked what the company was doing. He liked working with these customers, and the co-founder became the CEO then. I met Andrew after a couple of years, and he said that he was happy and not regretting the decision at all. And this illustrates one of the three scenarios that usually happen when there is this misalignment between co-founders. The second scenario is that the company struggles. There's bridge round after bridge round, then maybe some improvement, then again it goes down, but mostly it goes flat until something happens. Either there's reorganization, or the founders flip their roles, and then the one who was CEO anyway later leaves, or the investors pressure to change the leadership team, but usually some form of reorganization happens. And the third, it's a more rare situation that both co-founders realize that what they had initially started, they don't feel attached to, they don't desire to be doing it, and then they pivot into something else. I'm not saying that pivots are rare, because these happen when the company is struggling and both founders want to change into something that would be successful. But I'm saying those pivots are rare when the company already has traction and customers and investors and team and should continue in the direction, but then it changes the direction. And this illustrates what is alignment and what happens when there is no alignment. Alignment is when we as co-founders desire similar things and the company helps us to get what we desire. And it also means that what I desire helps you to get what you desire, and what you desire helps to get what I desire. And misalignment is when we want so different things that if I get what I want, it will block you from getting what you want, and vice versa. You can also think of vectors. If vectors are aligned, then the sum is great. And then the less they're aligned, the smaller the sum until it reaches zero. Also, with alignment, there's this situation that if there's misalignment, then for quite a long time, sometimes even years, you might not perceive that it is there. And then it seems that there's conflict somewhere else, setup or relationship or performance or attitude, while in fact these are just consequences and symptoms. And here I also want to remind what's the difference between alignment issues and setup issues. When we have alignment issues, meaning we desire separate different things, then we cannot fix them by forcing ourselves to desire something that we don't desire. It even sounds illogical that I'm saying this. So, because then instead of the external conflict with the co-founder, we would end up having an internal conflict, which anyway wouldn't work long term. While setup issues are such that there's something off in the way how we have set up the partnership, the company, and if we change it, nothing changes in terms of our desires. We still are doing what we desire to be doing in a way we desire to be doing it. Then you might ask, but what's the point of recording a program chapter about alignment if it cannot be fixed, and what's the point to you to watch it? Yeah. Well, the point is that you uncover it earlier if there is this misalignment, or you make it sure for yourself that everything is okay on the alignment side, and then move on to setup side. Because as I said, there can be the situation when misalignment is hidden for year, 2, even 3 years. Why waste this time, right? There will be 4 sections in this chapter. First, I will guide you through what are the elements of alignment. Then I will share the nature of misalignments, the reasons why we end up having misaligned partnerships and how it's keeping us locked in those situations. Then step 3, I will share how to evaluate your alignment with your co-founders. And then step 4, if there's misalignment, what to do about it.